Hi, parents. I hope you guys are doing well. Here we are again with another segment for Family Matters. We're ready to tackle on a new week and with a new discussion. So today's discussion is going to be money matters. And well, what does that mean? As many of us are going through consistent adjustments, for some, we've seen a big impact by either having been laid off or having a reduction in hours and what that really generally means for our household. So we can definitely understand that this is a huge stressor in the home. And so we wanted to really focus on the conversation between needs versus wants and learning to spend wisely, which sometimes can prove to be a little bit difficult if we have way too much time on our hands, and also having our children at home and them, you know, expressing their needs of something and tensions typically rising, right? So we wanted to give some examples of a tool that you can use to really clarify a budget for yourselves. Like many of us, we really find ourselves having to figure out how our finances or what our finances are going to look like for the next couple of weeks or even month, you know, because we don't know for how long this is going to last. And so I definitely want to remind you guys that you're not alone with feeling overwhelmed, with feeling stressed regarding finances. And so just taking a minute, you know, and trying to breathe, take a deep breath. And, you know, we're here to assist you guys as much as possible to kind of guide you through these different situations that we're all facing together. And so what are some of the things that you guys can do to help ease a lot of the tension? Well, first and foremost, finding out what you're eligible for. We do know that there's businesses that have to shut down their doors indefinitely, or even stores or you know, employers that are still trying to kind of figure out what it's they're going to be able to provide employees. And so definitely being informed with what your employer has or is still offering, or what services are available within the community that can give you some type of assistance. But not only that, really just prioritizing our own payments. So we might find ourselves in a situation where maybe there is not a whole lot of assistance out there, but really bringing it back home and seeing, okay, so what can I do to really maximize what I do have? Sometimes there isn't always enough money, right, coming in or that we have left over. So like I mentioned, prioritizing your payments, you know, can you make payment arrangements with any maybe credit cards or anything that you're owing, like your car payments, seeing what companies are offering, any type of deferment, and really being able to save yourself what you can right now, but also reminding yourself that eventually you are going to have to pay that back, right? So really understanding that if you're that one person that's always, you know, have taken pride, you know, in being able to make payments on time, this is not a reflection of your incapacity to do that. There is a situation that is out of your control, and we're having to really roll with the punches right now. Not something that you single-handedly chose to be in this situation. It is something that, like I mentioned, is out of your control. So just remind yourself of that. Be kind to yourself in that way, that this isn't a reflection of your self-worth. This is definitely something that, you know, was a surprise to many of us, and how it really affected us. So with that in mind, you know, like I said, prioritizing your payments. As I had mentioned last week, we're providing these packets for parents. It's the Club on the Go that you can pick up at any of your club sites, whether it's San Juan, South Far, or even Main Unit. Please come by and pick them up. And the reason why I'm saying this is because we actually attached these really, really cool monthly family budget forms. We gave you guys some examples. I don't know if you're really able to tell, but just how to prioritize payments and give yourself a visual breakdown of what your finances look like right now, for how long you'll be able to sustain yourself. And it really gives you a bit of a control regarding your money. And also, it's a really good way of figuring out, hey, okay, so maybe we were used to buying, I don't know, takeout 5 times out of the week. Well, now we're maybe going to minimize that to maybe once a week, and actually being able to make those adjustments even with your kids and letting them know, like, look, this is what we're dealing with. Our finances are going to be a little bit tight. It doesn't mean that we're not going to be able to do anything fun, but maybe just not as often. And so that's really the reason why we wanted to offer you guys different examples of how to do a monthly budget. Like I mentioned, we're giving, we attached it into the parent handbook. And so definitely go by and get it. It gives you guys really, really good tools just to sit down, even with yourself, if you're a single parent or if you're your partner, your spouse, anybody, just really sit down and evaluate where you are at financially, and teaching also your children the difference between a want versus a need. I know it's very common for us to say, oh, well, retail therapy, that helped me de-stress. Well, right now, maybe that's not the best option. And what that would do for you if you do decide, let me use retail therapy as a coping skill, is that going to hurt you in the long run? And is it going to put you more financial strain and increasing your stress as time goes by? So definitely reevaluating what your resources are at hand right now and being able to stretch out that dollar as much as possible. And just so that you're more in control of it and you can better plan for the next couple of weeks or a month, you know, depending how things are going to go. But at least it gives you more of a picture of what you have to work with. Again, you really definitely want to be that resource for yourself. And if you see, oh, there's deficits in this area, or, you know, I need assistance with my car payment or my light or my water, it definitely gives you that way of identifying what are the things that you need immediately, rather than feeling very overwhelmed and just not knowing where to start. It offers you some type of guidance as to where to go. Also, it's a really, really good opportunity to start teaching your kids on how to save money. And so we included this really, really cool activity. Do a piggy bank, you know. We included the materials you need to be able to do a piggy bank, and encourage your kids to help you clean the car, you know, maybe help clean between the couches. If they find coins, they can save it into a piggy bank, and really promoting a type of goal for themselves, like, oh, you want maybe a particular game. Well, you know, if you helping me clean up, if you find coins, you can put it in your piggy bank. And it's part of saving and saving towards something. So I hope that this kind of gives you guys the tools that you need just to guide yourselves in these, and you know, in the next couple of weeks or months, to, you know, like I mentioned, depending on how long this lasts. But it gives you more control and a little bit more peace of mind as to what you have available to you from yourself. And it guides you as to what resources you would need to look out for externally through community resources. I hope that this has helped. And if you guys have any questions or concerns, you know, please feel free to call to the club. We're there, you know, trying to be a resource to you guys, and you know, also be that support for you. And so, yeah, hopefully this helps. And if you guys have any questions or concerns, like I said, please reach out to us, you know, through message on Facebook, through Instagram, phone calls, whatever the case is. We're all in this together. And so we're still a big community, and we're a family unit. So, you know, here we are. We definitely continue to miss everybody. And hopefully this blows over soon. And I hope you guys have a great rest of your week. And I look forward to seeing you guys in the next talk.